Hello everyone. I welcome you to the lecture series of technical communication whose code is KAS301. You know students, why I keep repeating the code KAS301? Because it is the basic unit which will help you in every exam. So your paper will be identified through this code, not by the subject. So you have to learn the code. KAS301 is your code for technical communication. Same ways you will be having different codes for different subjects. Right, so let's proceed. Today we are going lecture 6, and this is the last lecture of unit 1. In the previous lecture we talked about technical writing and paragraph aspect of technical writing. Before that we did sentences. So after sentences it is about paragraphs, and after paragraph we are talking about the style which you are going to opt to write those sentences or a paragraph or that piece of document, whatsoever document. We have talked about so many documents in the previous videos. So let's get started. First of all, I will give you the outline of the video or this particular topic. So first is definition of technical style, which we are going to cover. After that, features of technical style, then types and methods of technical writing styles. So different types as well as the methods of writing those technical styles. So first of all, technical style. So first of all, let me come to the page. Yeah. So first of all, technical style. Style in technical writing, we refer to the way a person puts word together into sentences. So words together into sentences, the way a person is describing, arranges the sentences into paragraphs and organizes the paragraphs to frame a piece of writing to convey technical information clearly and accurately. So words gathered together make sentences, which gathered together makes paragraphs, and these well structuring of the paragraphs makes a piece of writing a clear or a proper way to communicate yourself to your particular audience or the specific audience. Style could be quite formal, as in technical report. If you're talking about technical report, scientific articles or a technical proposal, it will be very formal. On the other hand, if it is personal letter or a friendly email or a casual note, it could be informal. So the style changes formal to informal. So here there are several factors on which the style depends. One is audience, the other is communication content, and the third one is purpose of communication. How audience plays a role in deciding a style, because it is about the particular audience on for which you are going to write. Let's suppose if you are writing for a boss, for your boss or senior, the language, the words chosen will be very carefully chosen, and it will be quite formal in nature. But on the other hand, if you are sending it to your subordinate, so you can be little casual in that. So the style changes as per the audience, whosoever is your audience. Next is communication content. Communication content, because if it is a report, scientific article, technical proposal, a progress report or project report, then it will be quite formal. If it is a personal letter, a friendly email or things like that, then it changes the tone to a little informal one, right? Third one is purpose of communication. So you know, in the starting, I talked about the purpose of communication is to inform, to instruct, to persuade. So if it is case of the information, then the style will be different. If it is the case of instruction, giving instructions to somebody, then the style will be different. Like we talked about in the paragraphs, we are going to use chronological method or linear method depending on what type of content we are going to present. Automatically the style changes in that particular format or the method. Then the third one is persuade. If you are pushing someone, if you are convincing someone, if you are persuading someone, the style will change as per the need. Features. So there are different features of technical communication. So basically technical style. So number one is concise. You have to be concise when you are framing sentences in a technical piece of writing. Sentences should be clear and simple, communicating one concept per sentence. Ek concept hona chahiye ek sentence mein. Like if I say, I am very hungry, I want to eat pizza. So I am hungry and want to eat pizza. Say better hoga, main inko do sentence kar dun. Main kya kha rahi hu? Main pizza kha rahi hu. Kyun kha rahi hu? Because I am hungry. So these are two sentences, two alag concept. Although related sentences. So it should be clear, simple. Whenever you are writing, see, it is clear when you are following for installing a program, go to control panel, then displays. So there is a process, a clear instructions. Aisa to nahi hai ki high end vocabulary or high sounding words are being used to make you confusing. Aur aap har word ke liye pehle dictionary refer kar rahe ho. No, it is not the same case. So the concept should be very clear, in very clear sentences, in a very simple sentences. Technical communication from the starting, from the beginning I am talking about, should be straightforward, should be objective in nature, should be impersonal, unbiased, clear, simple. So these words you have to, you know, fit in your mind so as to work on technical communication. In situations where you want message to be unambiguous, unambiguous means confusing, not confusing. Simple, short, and direct sentences are the best way to proceed. So here I have given one example. If I read the sentence, keep this information on file for future reference. Rather than saying or being too much verbose, if I say file this information, it means the same thing, right? So jitna short and crisp sentence ho sake, that is better to frame rather than making it bulky with heavy loaded words, right? Next one is precise. Precision is the key. You should be very precise while writing or referring to anybody. Precise wording avoids ambiguity. Ambiguity means confusion, and ensures the correct information is conveyed to your reader. This is obviously essential to engineering settings where highly technical information, because you are very responsible people, you are very responsible human resource, manpower to our country, to our nation, to the world, where you will be disseminating technical information. So you have to be very precise, you have to be very accurate. You cannot afford to give information that is misleading. So you have to be since being technical, highly technical information, you have to be very precise, removing all the confusion and misunderstandings from the content which you are going to present in front of your specific audience. Example: the beaker water was placed in ice bath until it was cool. So you have to be specific. How? The beaker of water remained in the ice bath until its temperature reached 23 degrees Celsius. So instead of saying till it becomes cool, cool at what temperature? Right? If you're giving instruction to somebody, how that person will know that at this temperature I have to proceed the second step? No, you can't. So you have to be very specific so that a person can dip and check the temperature. 23 degrees Celsius? Yes. So this is the green signal to go and can work and can proceed to the second, third step, right? Next, objective style. Objective style, technical communication should get to the point. Remember the words, get to the point quickly. Readers need to know right away what to expect and if the document will meet their needs. So why do you write things? Newspaper mein there are specific pages which you will read, right? Because as a reader, this is what you want to read. Your father will be interested in some other pages, right? So it is as per the reader. So it should know what is being expected from the readers. And if the document is meeting their demands, it should be based on facts and information. It should be free from biasness. Koi biasness nahi honi chahiye, kisi ki taraf jhukav nahi hona chahiye. And no personal outlook. Apna insight. For example, TV channels, the anchors which are anchoring or the reporters which are giving reports regarding various things, it should not have a personal outlook. They should have an unbiased opinion, an impersonal opinion. They cannot favor any particular party. They cannot favor any particular religion. For them, everything is same. Same way for a technical communicator, he cannot be biased towards, let's suppose he is referring a Mi mobile or he is referring to Apple mobiles. So he cannot be biased. He has to be very specific and objective. If he is talking about Mi, Mi, then he will be talking about all the features of it. If he is a person who has been designated to talk about Apple or let's say any other brand, he cannot be biased. If he is a representative of a particular brand. I'm not talking about the comparison Wali videos or comparison in information that you refer to. No, I'm not talking about them. I'm talking about the specific information that you are disseminating. It should be well organized. Whenever you are writing, it should be well organized, very well structured, so that you do not lose the meaning of the particular sentence, piece of writing, or a paragraph. The order in which information is presented affects how easily it will be understood. As a communicator, you will need to make sure that any document, email, presentation you create has an intentional, logical, and consistent organization. A consistency ho, a proper flow ho of organization, logical progression ho, intended ho, kyunki technical communication is always intentional. It is intended, right? You target a particular specific audience to present your ideas. Now we come to types and methods of technical style. Here, there are various styles of writing. It depends upon the author, how to present his ideas, feelings, and attitudes to the problems he has undertaken to explore. So different methods we are types we are talking about, different methods we are talking about of narrative style. One way is to narrative writing. Narrative matlab kuch narrate karna. In this a situation, event, or a person is presented with the element of drama and surprise in it. For example, biographies, autobiography. So very less chances are there that you will touch this domain if you are writing technically. Descriptive writing, yes, this is one thing which is part and parcel of your stream, of your background. In this, we describe an object, so you must be having so many products to explain or describe an appliance, a process, a situation in an objective manner. Objective manner means not being biased towards anything, being unbiased, having an impersonal attitude. No personal outlook should be attached to it, or no personal element should be attached to it. Here, the effort is to present the thing as it is. For example, description of a clinical thermometer. A clinical thermometer is an instrument used by doctors to measure the temperature of human body and so on. So here, you are describing an object. Next one is explanatory writing. Explanatory means explain karna kuch bhi. Isko expository writing bhi kehte hain. In this, a composite picture of a problem or situation is presented by putting its positive and negative aspects. Then a conclusion is arrived at by reconciling different realities. So pros and cons both are being discussed. Explain kara jata hai properly. Next is argumentative and analytical writing. In this type of writing, a clinical, critical analysis of the materials and their problem is done. And then a standpoint is developed. For example, is the depiction of violence on TV responsible for the rise of crime? So it is an open-ended question. So you can argue. Argue means to keep your point. You can analyze the situation and you can give your arguments aspect, either positive or negative. Should the presentation of violence on TV be banned? Give your personal opinion. So here you are giving your personal opinion on that. So this comes under the heading of argumentative, because you are analyzing the situation and then presenting your view. And that view is arguments that you are going to present. Next comes scientific writing. So scientific writing is basically, just a second. So scientific writing is just a technical style where any objective and systematic presentation comes under the ambit of scientific writing. Example ke through samjho, the descriptive writing on solar cells is an example of scientific writing. Solar cells is a part of engineering or a technical domain where it is being explained because it attempts to describe an object, a process or a situation as it is same with budget. So this is scientific and technical. अब financial लोगों के लिए क्या होगा? Budget को describe करना या कोई budget proposal रखना. So that will be scientific and technical writing. Next is journalistic writing. When you write journals, it requires quick composition on some day-to-day significant issues. It must be short, depending on the column to be published, such as articles on the editorial page, on business. Sports pages, etc. It is normally accompanied with an eye-catching photographing. Photographs are being given. Journals you write for a day-to-day significant issue. So, ये ज़्यादातर magazines and newspaper publishing industries में it is being used. Even if you publish a book or an article, you might be requiring certain tables and pictures to represent your ideas. So that also comes into journalistic writing when you are writing a journal and presenting some ideas with the help of some pictures or graphs. Then comes itinerary. Whenever you plan to go out, you make an itinerary. So these are the places where we'll be able to go. So this is also one of those styles. It is an action. Like technical writing is totally not into the profession of engineering. Technical writing, if you are from a medical field, having a medical prescription, so writing medical prescriptions or documents related to it comes under technical heading only. It is technical communication. वो आपकी field से related है. Technical communication is आपकी field से related. So medical people have that field, so they will be writing documents, technical documents as per their fields. अब अगर I have a tour, travel and tourism company, and I am preparing itineraries for different people, that is technical document for me. That is a formal mode of communication to my clients, to my customers, right? So it is an action plan for a journey or tour to place. The plan includes the routes, places to visit, activities to be done. Every professional person should plan his or her actions for a journey, right? So take it as your homework to write an itinerary for a place. Although we can't go in this situation, COVID-19, but at least this much you can do, that you can write an itinerary in your particular diary or your notebook. Then checklist. You must be aware of checklist. You must have seen so many checklists so far. Whenever you want to do something, most usually you check mentally the what, the when, the where, and how of that activity. So how you are going to do it, you make various points, and that points actually is the checklist. If it is somewhat important, once you do this, you are ready for that activity. Taking a very simple example from your day-to-day life, when you go to the grocery shop, you make a list of items. So that is checklist only. You make a list of items. Now doing it professionally comes under the heading of technical style, right? Last one is definitions. You must have seen so many definitions. You must have studied in every topic. In fact, definition is included. आज आप पढ़ रहे हो, there will be some day when you will be framing certain definitions for others and others will be studying that. Generally, we can describe people and things. When anybody asks about anything or any people, we describe in our own precise terms. We actually define the purpose. Define a person if we are talking about a person. Definition should not be vague. It should not be vague. It should be very specific. You must have seen mostly one or two lines mein definitions are over. Very rarely it goes to more than two lines. Should provide a clear picture of what you are going to explain. Like with this thermometer. It is a clinical instrument that is used to check temperatures and it will be used by different people, doctors and a common people, which can be easily visualized by the listener. Jab aap sun rahe ho, it is an instrument which is used to measure temperature. So aap usko visualize kar pa rahe ho, picturize kar pa rahe ho apni aankhon ke aage. For example, calculator. Yahan pe calculator ka example, a small electronic device for calculating. तो एक स्मॉल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस है जिससे आप कैलकुलेट कर सकते हो. सो कैलकुलेटर की इमेज हैज कम इनटू योर आईज. सो डेफिनेशन शुड बी वेरी स्पेसिफिक, वेरी शॉर्ट. इट शुड नॉट बी वेग एंड स्पेसिफिक टू द नीड. अननेसेसरी वर्ड्स शुड नॉट बी इंक्लूडेड इन द डेफिनेशन. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द स्टाइल. वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट 9 स्टाइल्स ऑफ टेक्निकल राइटिंग और 9 मेथड्स ऑफ टेक्निकल राइटिंग इन विच आर डॉक्यूमेंट्स कुड बी फ्रेम्ड. Which includes technical documents as well as general documents that you are framing. So we are just talking about the technical styles. कि बहुत सारे styles होते हैं जिसमें आप लिखते हैं, right? I hope this whole concept is clear to you. The content is clear to you about technical style. And here we end our first unit, which gives you a basic, because the heading of the unit was fundamentals of technical writing. So it gives you the basic outline of technical communication. Now from unit 2 we will proceed to writing in wherein technical reports, journal writing, technical research articles writing, then various other articles like seminar, conference paper writing, proposal. So you will be guided how or what is the structure of those, how you can frame them, how you can write, because with going gradually you have to write certain papers. It will be you will be facing various projects, you will be bounded with different companies in your this tenure only, in your BTech tenure only, wherein you have to write proposals as well. So you always get lost that from where we can gather information about them. So there is no need for that, no need for the confusion. We are going to discuss it and you will understand it and learn it, how the things are being framed. Thank you so much.